That to upload. Hi guys, sorry we're late.
Welcome. Yes,
guess
we are
whose
late.
Fault it was. Me.
It's okay. Actually, this has just kind of been a screwy morning or day or whatever you want to call it. Yeah. Sunday Funday. We just learned, like literally right now while we were setting up, that YouTube has a new policy that you cannot do a live webcast using a mobile device unless you have at least 1,000 subscribers. And I literally just found that out. Like, they didn't send me an email or anything, so.
Just right now.
I didn't know, and we were trying to figure it out, like, how could we make this work? Because you guys know, normally that's what we do. We stream live on YouTube and on Facebook, so that's not happening today. We're just going to record it and then upload it. You'll still be able to watch it on our YouTube, which is, Wine, Women, and Song on YouTube, so you can find it there. You can also, of course, rewatch it later here on Facebook if you're not watching with us live. So available both ways, and we apologize for that kookiness. We just didn't know. But here we are, and happy Sunday. Like we were saying, this is episode number 11. So we're happy that you could join us if you're watching live, and thank you for watching if you're seeing this later. We do this every Sunday at 1 o'clock. So in case you were wondering, and you weren't sure, it is every Sunday at 1, and we drink local booze and we talk music, which is what we're about to do here today.
Yes, we are. So today we are going to have a couple of wine choices.
Yummy.
So this is from BOGLE. And it's a Sauvignon Blanc.
If you love someone, you bring them BOGLE, guys.
BOGLE.
This is the best wine. Like, and it's just literally right down the road from me. Like,
yeah.
Right down, you just go down Freeport, and you just keep on trucking to, what is that? Is that considered Clarksburg? I think it's Clarksburg.
BOGLE Vineyards.
You can Google it. BOGLE.
And they're pretty, it's pretty tasty wine. Everything they have, I believe, is pretty tasty. And it's inexpensive.
Yeah.
I mean, if you get it on sale, like, it's super inexpensive.
Yeah, it's really good. For the quality, it's amazing.
So this is our first Sauvignon Blanc. And then I didn't know that, I'm assuming this is a red, but I didn't know you could put Pinot in the refrigerator.
Oh, yeah.
Because this was in the refrigerated section. So I'm like, oh, yum.
Cold wine.
Yeah, so this is a Pinot Noir. Okay. Yeah, and this is also from BOGLE, so we're going to try this. I've not had cold red wine before. I know your mom puts ice in her wine.
You know what?
Like a weirdo,
my mom, she calls herself the tacky wine drinker, and
she's like, just give me the box.
No, but it's true, I know, right? Like, wine cooler time.
Yeah.
But honestly, I have cured her because I've kind of like, you know, on a couple different occasions, let her taste like my wine or a wine that I chose without the ice in it, and I've converted her. So now she can forego the wine, which is good. It's always really awkward when we're ordering like a really nice wine, and she's like, can I also have a cup of ice? But I've cured her, so yay.
So we'll start with this one.
Yeah, the Sauvignon Blanc by BOGLE.
And I love that they have the screw-off caps now.
Yeah,
I love
that.
It's
nice for if you wanted to take this like on a picnic.
Yeah.
You don't have to mess with the opener. That is fantastic, actually. Easy access. We like it.
Tell me, how much wine do you put
in? I think that's good,
I would
right?
put in like the whole glass.
Well, I think a pour. I think a pour is considered like 4 ounces, right? Because there's 4 glasses in a bottle. So,
well, I guess when you're drinking that,
we'll be sippy-sippy-sippy-in. Woohoo! Okay. Cheers, everyone! And if you are having a little drink with us, let us know. And we will say cheers to you as well.
Yes.
Good. Yeah, that's good.
I love white wine.
Oh, and I was going to say, we are listening to this fantastic neato old record. I'm not sure where I picked this up. It's the original Golden Hits of the Great Blues Singers, Volume Number 2.
Awesome.
So that's what we're listening to, so that I don't have to hear my crappy neighbor's gah, construction sound today. So a little blues here on a Sunday, a little wine. And I think first off, we're going to get on to a couple events. This was a great week in music up here. We had a bunch of just amazing shows that happened
in one night.
That's how Sacramento rolls, you guys. Like, it's pretty funny.
We've been
Hi, Axel. We miss you. And thanks again for everybody for watching. But yeah, we went to 3 shows. It was my mama's birthday, for anybody who didn't know. And so we did it upright. We went to 3 different clubs. We saw 3 different genres of music. All on Wednesday. All on Wednesday. So it was a great time. We first off went to the Momo Lounge. There's a great series of music that's happening. Hi, Elvis. So good to see you, Elvis. We're going to talk a lot about you,
yes,
sir, today. Got lots to say about you. All good. Anyways, we went out. We saw at the Momo Lounge. We got to see the Hucklebucks. They're one of our very favorite blues groups. They do kind of like a jump blues,
jump blues swing.
Little swing.
Yeah.
Really good. I mean, they're always... You can just count on it. It's just going to be a fun time with them. So started off there, had some snacks and some wine over at Momo Lounge. Swell Productions puts those shows on. And it's bourbon and blues. And it's, is it every Wednesday? So it's every Wednesday. So if you're bored around town, you can always go see a good show on a Wednesday night. And they're early shows too, so you can still get to work, the next day.
Yeah, the doors open at 6:30. I think the show
5:30.
starts. 5:30.
Oh,
5:30. The show starts at 6:30. Okay.
But that gives you time. You can get a good little booth seat, make friends with your neighbors. story time later. Get you a snack. They have very good service. They have really good food. It's the same food that they have at Harlow's, so it's a great setup there. But yeah, saw the Hucklebucks. They did 3 sets.
Yes, they most of the bands always do 3 sets.
Yeah, it was amazing. They had a couple of special guests, including our girl, Diana O'Brien from Diana and the Cherry Kings, was there in the building, and they were so gracious to call her up and let her do an Elvis number with them, which you can see on our YouTube channel, Wine, Women, and Song. We have video of Diana sitting in and singing with the Hucklebucks if you wanted to check that out. She is all that.
Yes.
So it was a great start to the evening, and then per Mama's request, she wanted to go see her boyfriend, Bobby Dixon, who was playing over at Goldfields, and that is sort of our country venue, but they do
like a lot of different things, but I think originally they wanted it to be,
the concept was more country. Like country outlaw,
but they do a lot of like country outlaw,
they do some
and
punk
like
rock
heavy like, I don't know what you call it these days. Not heavy metal, but it's more screamy metal, like
screamo.
Hard. No, because screamo, I figured was.
I sound
old. Something else.
Yeah, I don't know. We could ask my daughter. She would know what all of these different
but,
things are.
But it's a really fun place. And the little the guy that puts on the show, Simon, he's really cool.
And adorable.
Adorable.
We love him.
Yes, we love Simon. Mm-hmm.
He makes Goldfield he makes Goldfield cool.
Yeah.
We'll just leave it there.
Yes.
But yeah, so we went and saw Bobby Dixon. He Bobby Dixon, if you guys don't know, he was in the Dead Billies down in Southern California. He's old school OG Americana punk rock guy. He's been around for a long time. You may know him best from the Cash Prophets, which is a Johnny Cash tribute band that we are madly in love with. And most recently, he does a little thing called Unchained, which is Bobby and maybe 1, maybe 2 other players. Sometimes it's just him all by himself. He plays acoustic. And sometimes there's a Johnny Cash song in there, but sometimes there's some of his really good originals in there. He'll throw in like a weirdo, like, you know, maybe a Glen Campbell or even a Carr song or Echo and the Bunnymen or just something
just
really
random.
And but he does it in the style of like a Johnny Cash outlaw style. So it's really exciting to watch. But my favorite part of that show was he brought an accordion player, this dynamite kid.
Yeah, so good.
This little baby. I don't even know how old that little baby was. Probably barely old enough to even get in the bar. But he was so cute and he was so good. And I didn't catch his name or anything. But, he just added like a completely different dimension to the Johnny Cash, Bobby Dixon experience.
Yeah, it was just so good.
Kind of mesmerizing.
Yeah.
I mean, how often do you go to a club or you go to a show and you get to see somebody play an accordion? It was so cool. It was so cool, you guys.
Diana, we mentioned you.
We're going to talk about you some more. but anyway, so yeah, so that was really great. We unfortunately couldn't stay for very long.
But I
stayed a little bit longer.
So the headline Unchained opened for this person called Lincoln. And we were kind of like, oh, there's drums, there's guitars.
Yeah, it's going to be a full band.
It was a one-man band.
Yeah. And it was amazing.
She was kind of in love. She was a little smitten. She was a little in love with the whole situation.
I mean, Diana, her husband, Tommy, and I stayed, and we were like, wow. Like, this guy is
doing
so
everything.
Cool, and next time he comes through town, we're coming back.
Like, yeah, he was really good.
Yeah.
Snappy dresser, kind of a good-looking dude.
Yeah, he was, like, dressed kind of like punk, but...
Yeah.
Not. Like, it was like, just really weird.
I kind of wish I could have stayed for that full show because it looked like it was going to be good, and I did catch some of your video.
I think you can probably post some of that on Insta, right?
Yeah.
Insta page.
Yeah. You can send me the video and I'll post it. That's the other thing, you guys. If you are watching us, you know, or if you pay attention, subscribe to our YouTube channel, we have videos there, but we also do put video clips of the shows that we go to on our Instagram, which is Wine Women and Song Gals. So do follow us and we will follow you back.
So the Lincoln thing was fun, and then we headed out to meet these ladies, Shonda and her mom.
Yep, then we skedaddled over to the Torch Club, everybody's favorite little dive,
blues dive, honky,
so much fun. But the Tropicali Flames were playing, which I've seen video of them, but I have not had the good fortune of seeing them, and it absolutely delivered everything that I thought it would. I was really kind of smitten. It's all of the goodness of Zach Sapanor and his bass and CW, you know, with guitar. But in addition to that, which we know and love with a couple different sort of outfits that he's got going on, they have just this amazing dude on saxophone that just absolutely will melt your face off.
Yeah.
Like, he is a rockin' sax player. Entertaining, fun to watch, matches Zach perfectly with the antics and the showmanship and... you know, snappy dresser again, and just really animated and super fun to watch, you guys. Like, check out Tropicali Flames. Like, they are so good. I mean, they're just going to burn Sacramento down. They are, in my mind, one of the best. Like, I absolutely enjoyed myself completely. Mom was grooving. We had just a great time. It was super fun.
And just because we have to shout out the whole band, our favorite drummer, Larry Carr.
Larry Carr, Care Bear. Larry Bear, Care Bear. We love him. So yeah, it was a good time. It was quite a Wednesday night. I feel like I got my whole week's worth of music in one night because I did. And, you know, Sacramento just seems to be that way. It's like, you know, there's like nothing for a few days and then all of a sudden it's like there'll be two or three days of really concentrated good times. So, but yeah, we had a great time for Mom's birthday and it was definitely a bonus week for us as far as music goes. It was really good times. And we got to see Elvis there too. That was really nice to see Elvis. Mm-hmm. And I swiped this awesome poster. We're going to talk more about Elvis today. But look at, he let me steal this poster. Look at this. See this? Look at this guy. I don't know who does his artwork and who does his posters, but it's really always awesome. I mean, it's just really good. It was such a good poster flyer. I just needed to have it. But this is for Elvis Cantu at the Torch Club, which again is one of our favorite little venues, and it's on June 7th, and I'm sure you'll be seeing these up and around town. And if not, here it is. So good job, Elvis. We love watching you. And to that end, he is also, because he's a madman and he's a really hard worker, he's going to be actually doing a show this evening. If you are in the Gold Country or if you feel like taking a little drive, Elvis Cantu is playing tonight at the California Club in Auburn, California. So
7 and 10.
Yeah, a little drive up the road there. California Club's cool. It's like a cool little intimate joint, you know? It's like a real, like, old school kind of...
It's an old dive, but it's in the beautiful part of downtown Auburn. They have hardwood floors for any dancers that want to go out.
Yeah.
But it's just a cool little dive bar, basically.
Super cheap drinks, I'm just saying.
Yep.
Pretty convenient parking. There's parking in and around, and it's like in a little district of Auburn where you could kind of hop around and go to some other places if you wanted to. You could have dinner at the Auburn Ale House. They have really good food there. It's a cool location. It's a beautiful drive up there, especially this time of year. Things are turning all green, and it's getting real pretty, you know. So, yeah, that would be worth the drive. Or if you're up in that area, Grass Valley, Auburn, Nevada City, make the trek down and go see Elvis because he's amazing, and it's going to be a good show.
Yeah,
yeah.
I love that.
Yep.
And just to put it out there, today is Sacramento Western Swing Society, and they have playing today, the Sactown Playboys are playing 1 to 3.
Another Sac,
which I should be
band.
There.
I know.
But I'm not. Yeah. So they're performing today. They're their headlining band, and the way they work there is the headliner, the guest plays first, and then they have their house band play next. So, and that's until about 5:30, I believe.
Yeah.
But if you are in the area, go down to the Machinist Hall off of Sunrise Boulevard and check out this amazing band.
Yeah, it's always a good time. I know we've talked about it a few times on our webcast thing, but it's always a good time.
I'm like hot right Ooh. Now.
Yeah, you are.
It's because my hair is down, I think.
Oh. Well, it's time to flip the record, friends. Okay. Let's flip the record.
So, yeah, that'll be a good time. Anyway, we like to promote that. We haven't decided if we're just going to skip this first Sunday because I am a member and I should support it.
Well, but truly, I mean, it goes from 1 to 5. So we still could, if we left at 2, we could still have potentially 3 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have to work it out.
But we really want to see the headlining bands a lot of
True.
The time, so.
True.
And they start at 1.
That's true. We'll figure it out. We're learning as we go. We're figuring it out as we go. And we appreciate your feedback as well. So definitely let us know what you think also. So we both made a few notes here. There were some things I wanted to go over. Just quickly, everybody knows it's Viva time.
Yeah.
Viva! If you're going, have a great time.
I'm not going.
I was still kind of on the fence. I don't know. I don't know. I just don't think it's in the cards. Like, it's Easter weekend, which I hate when they do that. And
it's
they do
been
that.
Easter weekend forever, though.
But the last couple ones were not
because they had someone booked the Orleans, even though they know we kind of have the Viva people have the Easter weekend lockdown. They've thrown in some, like, weird, like, luge competition thing at one point, like something weird on Easter weekend when they know that Tom always puts on Easter weekend.
So that sucks. And if you're going, have a great time. I will be living vicariously through you, it looks
so
like.
So will I this year. I'm going to miss all my pals.
Because boohoo, she's going to Europe. Oh, cry. So sad. Whatever. She's going to have a great time too. I'm living vicariously through her also. And then I didn't want to spend too much time on that because we've talked about it a few times. But also, Berry Festival is coming up. If you're here in the region, the Berry Fest, it's a great family day or weekend, I should say. It's May 11th and 12th. I've booked music for both days, so you can come out and see some very awesome live acts. We have everything from Tejano to country to jazz. And then our pals, the Out of Sights, are coming up from LA to do a special couple of sets there on the Saturday, which is the 11th. So make time for that if you can. Bring the whole family. It's a very family-friendly event. Beautiful grounds up there in Roseville. Feedmeberries.com is that website, so you guys can check out the whole day's events. There's 8 stages of entertainment. It's going to be a blast. So I didn't want to spend a whole lot of time on that because I've talked about that before also, but just wanted to touch on that as a reminder. It is coming up, and it is going to be a blast.
If you are on Facebook, there is an invite.
Yes.
So.
Or you can just go to the website. Yeah. That's easy peasy. You can totally do that. And then also on that same sort of wavelength, the Out of Sights will be here for that weekend. They're going to be here, I want to say it's the Friday and the Saturday, and they're doing multiple shows. I have them booked at the Stag in Woodland. I have them booked at the Berry Festival, and then they're, I think, going to be playing... Where am I missing? I'm missing something. There's a flyer and an invite up on Facebook for the Out of Sights mini tour, but I have them... Oh, Swabby's on the River here in Sac, right on the river. Gorgeous. It's kind of a pirate-themed outdoor bar if you've never been there. They have a really cool outside stage and really good food. It's fun there, so check that out. And then I was going to, because I haven't talked about this one, the Hillbilly Robot Fest music event is happening this month, the month of April. And when I first saw the flyer, I guess I didn't read it very carefully. I thought it was like one day because it's like all of these really good Americana bands. Turns out it's like over the course of the entire month. So you can check that out on Facebook if you just, you know, put in the search Hillbilly Robot into the event. There's like a bunch of different bands that have, you know, made an event invite for that. So you can see what's going on. But it goes from April 6th through the 20th next weekend. It's going to be Bobby Dixon with his cash profits of the full Johnny Cash tribute, along with our buddy Sean Cahoon, who we dearly love. If you love that real deal old school, that really good country music, like Merle Haggard, if you like that kind of a sound, he's so good. But yeah, so it's going to be both those guys next weekend. And like I said, you can find those details out over there on Facebook. There's also a website. It's ShelbyAshPresents.net. So www.ShelbyAshPresents.net. And you can get tickets and see the details and see that cool flyer that they have. Eva already mentioned the Western Swing Society, yes. So we won't get into that. I did see there is another cool event on May 11th coming up, and it's a car show with the Battle and Bettys, which is a pinup troupe that is local here to this area. And it's going to be up in Citrus Heights. It's called Cruisin' for Canines. It's with the Cappuccino Cruisers. I think it looks like it looks fun. And they have, it's a benefit obviously for the SPCA. So, you know, that's always worthy, you know, taking care of the SPCA is a good cause.
Veterans and animals. Those are the causes that
that's our jam. Yeah. We love those. So that's going to be a really good time. There is also a Facebook invite for that, for the Battle and Bettys. Again, that's called the Cruisin' for Canines car show with the Cappuccino Cruisers. And there's not a website, but there is a phone number if you want more details, you want to bring your ride out. I think the cost for the show is $20, which I think always $20.
Yeah. $25
But you can get a hold of Ray or Chris, and that phone number is 916-988-6376. The hours of the car show are 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. So I don't know what else is going on out there, but there's pinups and there's cars, and that's good enough for
probably
me.
Probably food, like barbecue. Probably, they usually always do like some sort of barbecue food. Where is it at?
Citrus Heights. It just had like a street address, so I don't know if it's like in a, like maybe a shopping parking lot or something like that. I'm not totally sure.
Okay.
But like I said, you can definitely look up those details on the Facebook. And I was going to bring up yours truly, while this one's in Europe, is going to be hanging out with my pals, Elvis Cantu, who we talk about incessantly. Elvis Cantu is bringing up the amazing Josh Sorheim again. Lucky me.
Yeah, there better be lots of video.
So I get to also do a little DJing with them, and I get to see them again. And what a great time we had seeing them live. It's going to be so much fun. And that also is going to be at the California Club, which is, again, up there in Auburn. So hope you can make it up May 4th. I think that's going to be a really beautiful spring day with some great music and come up.
Yeah, that'll be fun. I'm super bummed. But
I know, we're going to miss her.
Do you not follow Elvis Cantu or Josh Sorheim. I always mess it up, and I love him. So
he's great.
You should follow them. They have Instagrams. They have Facebooks. Mm-hmm. So you should follow them. They always post their music.
I know Josh always puts up a bunch of yummy videos.
Yeah.
Like, if you want to get a feel for his sound, he's so good at self-promotion.
Yeah.
He's so good at putting those little video clips and stuff up. He's also, his Instagram's really cool, like old photos. If you dig like old vintage stuff, he's always got cool stuff posted. So definitely check that show out. Check those guys out. Follow them for sure.
And they book everywhere. So you might be a friend of mine and you may live in a different country. Well, I know Elvis for sure is international.
Oh, definitely. And I think Josh is too.
I think
he is too. Check those guys out for sure. I wanted to mention that. And let's see, you wanted to talk about, and we should talk about, coming up on April 10th, right? Is that a 10th, sweetheart?
Yes.
So April 10th,
it's
you guys.
Wednesday, next Wednesday.
It's like Attack of the Dan. So Jesse Daniel, along with Danny Morris.
It's like going to be like eye candy.
It's going to be like night. Dan Fest. Dan Fest. 2019.
Yes.
I love it. So Torch Club, super fun. We don't have to say any more about that, but those are two really fun Americana acts. Danny Morris is amazing, and I know that's going to be a quality show, so you definitely want to check them out.
Yeah, and I think Jesse Daniel is playing with Big Sandy. That's kind of how I looked him up, because I think when Big Sandy comes, I think it's in August at Harlow's.
I didn't even see.
Look, she knows stuff I don't know.
I think in Jesse Daniel's opening, I'm like, who is this guy?
Who is he?
And then it was like,
we gotta
know. Oh my God.
Yeah. He's kind of a little bit on the yummy side, you guys, if you didn't know.
And he's a good artist as well.
It's going to be good times. Not just to look at.
Right.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
So, well, I'm excited for that. That's going to be fun. And then it looks like, are you going to this?
I am going to that.
You're such a bitch. She's going to go see on 4/9. So is that Tuesday?
Tuesday.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the Pixies with Weezer at the Golden One Center. She's going to an arena show, you guys.
I do that sometimes.
Big girl shit.
Sometimes. Yeah. That'll be fun.
Yeah.
I haven't seen the Pixies in a couple years. So.
Yeah. And I think I saw that Weezer is going to be coming back too on a tour in the summertime. Mm. I saw something online. I don't know.
I'm a fan, but not a fan.
Pixies is
since I was a wee
for sure
gal.
For sure. Greater than Weezer. So that's gonna be awesome. That's so cool. You got tickets and you get to go. I'm not going. But that'll be fun. And everybody who got tickets, good for you. Have a good time. We want to see your pictures. And your show day fun times. Yeah. So share those with us.
And we already talked about that.
We did talk about Elvis.
All day.
Before I just go off the rails again, I think we need a little refill.
Okay, so we'll do this one. So we're going to do the BOGLE Pinot Noir.
Oh, we have to uncork.
This is an uncorking one?
I don't know how to do that. Oh, I do. I have a cheater
thing. Not a professional. That's why I like the twist off.
Twist off is nice. Oh, it's like somebody got this one kind of started for us here. Ooh, is that harmonica on that record?
This album is so good. I was like jamming down to it a little while ago.
Nothing like the blues on a Sunday, honestly. Yes. Like, that's always a good time. Like, you know, whatever you got going on, if you're cleaning the house, washing the dog, cleaning your car, you put on some blues, it makes it instantly a great time. Especially if you got some good wine to go with it. Or a cold beer or whatever. So I'm cheating. I got my little cheater thing here. Let's see if I can get this going here. All right. There it goes.
It's like, hello. Okay.
Hello, let's party. Okay, and then we do this. All right. Okay, well, we didn't have like a fancy, we don't have new glasses, so.
It's okay.
Yeah. All right, let's just give this a whirl here. It is a beautiful red wine. I feel like that's weird that it's cold. Why is it refrigerated?
I didn't know Pinot could be
hella weird.
Refrigerated. It's just kind of shocking to me. Do any of you wine connoisseurs know anything about that?
I know, holler at us. Like, do you drink chilled red wine? That's weird.
I'm kind of scared.
It's like a BOGLE twofer, though. Awesome. Cheers. We didn't really aerate it either. It's a little dry, mm-hmm. Not sweet. Mm-mm.
But that's okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's a definitely a contrast from the white wine, for sure.
Maybe we needed a palate clean.
It's very, very, very smooth, but it is, like, really dry. It's surprisingly dry for me.
Yeah. It's good.
Yeah, it is good. It's because it's BOGLE, which is our very, very fave. It's my fave for sure. Okay, now we can get down to business. I talked to a few different friends this week about music and music in our area and booking music and shows and what makes a show successful. And it was something I was like, you know, I really want to get down on this. And I've talked to a couple other people about it. And they're like, yeah, you should talk about it. You should address it. And the truth of the matter is, it's like where we live up here in Northern California, it's almost like our musicians just don't even have a fighting chance. And what I mean by that is like no matter how talented you are, no matter how good you are at self-promotion, no matter, you know, how many wonderful CDs or even records that you've made, it's like this area is really against you. I am personally not a musician. I've never played music. I'm a person who has followed musicians and dated musicians and booked shows since I was 15 years old. And that was a hell of a long time ago. We'll leave it at that. But it's like, it is, it's such a difficult mountain to climb up here. And I, you know, I've talked to different people about, you know, well, what will work and how can I, and, you know, and then I saw, and I don't know if you saw this, did you see that thread where our friend Mr. Boggs had chimed in about, somebody was saying some very, not very nice things about our pals over at Shady Lady. And saying that it's not a real jazz venue and it's not a real jazz club and it's not, and they're, you know, they're just basically in a nutshell, they're not giving the fair pay to the musicians that play there. And it's a huge thread.
What?
It's a huge thread. And Jason Boggs, if you get to see this, I have to say hats off to you, sir, because you countered and made your points with such poise and elegance and composure that I'm super
him.
Impressed. I do too. Like, we're in love with him.
Yes.
We're in love with you, Jason Boggs. But I just wanted to
let's make out.
P.S.
I'm always like, Jason. I just had to throw that in there because I love him.
But he's essentially adorable. Like these two different conversations that I had with these two different kind of groups of people and, you know, the different responses that I saw just prompted me to kind of want to talk about it and make a few points. This is one of my favorite records. Look at this.
That's amazing.
It's Johnny Ace. That's it's crazy. So delish, you guys. Let's listen to this now because it's so, so good and I wanted to share it with you. So I pulled this one out. I have sort of like a bag over here with just like sort of some of my favorite ones. This is such a good
yeah,
one.
Yeah, so I mean, let us know if you enjoy this music that we're putting on in the background.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how much of it you can actually hear.
We're glad that we're able to give
it, that it's to good background. Oh, I am. Hi, Facebook. It's good background noise. I love this one. Do you guys remember this song? Do you remember this?
Listen. This is like an oldie but a goodie. This is so cholo.
No, but for me, this takes me back in the way back when I was a kid. I was a huge Stephen King fan. And this is in the movie Christine. Oh, so scary. This song is like scary because of that movie for me. It's like I'm all, but it's still very good. It's delicious.
Yes.
But anyway, getting back on topic over here.
Yes.
I just wanted to talk about that stuff because, you know, basically it was a group of different musicians chiming in and talking about the Shady Lady, which is one of our favorite music venues, and talking about how it's not a real jazz club, and talking about how, you know, they're not giving these musicians their proper pay. You know what? You're not getting the proper pay. You know what? We're in Sacramento, my friends, and guess what? Top pay you're gonna make here, top pay is like $300. I don't care how good you are. I don't care how many friends and fans and family you have. That's what we're dealing with here, you guys. Like, that's, unfortunately, that's the reality. And it's not because these, you know, horrible club owners. What happened? Did we just time out? We were having so many technical difficulties here, you guys. Our YouTube just like timed out on us. Anyway, I'll talk over here to you, Facebook. Anyways, and it's just like, I saw all of the different responses, and the truth is I have been booking music in this town like over 15 years now. I know the ins and the outs of the business and how it works. And yeah, you know what? It's not fair. And it's not fair that somebody can't just go, here's a check for $1,000, you're amazing. But these clubs, and this is the rub, you guys, this is like where the rubber meets the road. Being where I am on the promoter side of things.
And I've seen that backside.
When you're on that side of things, you get to see that sort of like where the club is coming from and what they're doing and you know, what their perspective is. It's like, you know, I mean, they have to pay money for a security guy, which is paid by the hour, and they are not cheap, my friends. They have to pay for their entire staff. And if you're bringing in extra people, that means you are now bringing in extra staff as well to service all the people that are going to be there. Whether it's your mom and she got in for free or somebody paid a cover, doesn't matter. It's extra folks that they have to like have in place, to pay for that. So, you know, that's an added expense. If they have a sound system, they're paying for that sound system.
or they're paying for somebody to run that sound system. It's expensive. You know, all of these different factors kind of go together to make it. So, I mean, some of these clubs that actually, I have talked to so many venues that have maybe they've done music and now they don't do music. And they all say the same thing. It's like, I can't afford to do it. It doesn't bring in enough money. I'm not making any money on it. It's not helping my venue. It's too much work. That's also another issue. And so they just don't do it, you know? So, and then, you know, to some of my friends who maybe haven't played a lot of shows in this area, you're also competing with a hell of a lot. You're not just competing against other musicians or other bands or other groups. You are also competing against the lifestyle, which is Northern California. Northern California, the people that live here, they're not here because they're here for the arts. They're not here because they're here for culture. They're not here because they want to see live music 4 or 5 nights a week. They're here because they're breeding and they have 10 kids and they need an affordable place to live, or they're here.
Which is not the fact, the case any longer in Sacramento. It's very expensive to live here.
It's gotten more expensive, but I mean, if you are comparing this to like the Bay Area.
Yeah.
This is a bar, and I know that because I also sell real estate for anybody who didn't get that. So I know a little bit about that market as well. It's like, this is a cheap place to live and have a family.
And people want to raise their children.
Yeah, we have like good schools, you know, but you're competing against that. You're competing against just the lifestyle of Northern California, which is people who want to go mountain biking and people who want to go skiing and people who want to do yoga and people who want to go do water sports and be on the river and whatever else they got going on, which, I mean, you know, that's a lot. You know, there's people that just would rather mow their lawn and watch Netflix because that is the community we live in. This is not a hotbed of culture. It's not a hotbed of music. So you're competing against that. So it's like, you know, number one, I guess what I would say is like, well, where is the solution? Where can we kind of meet in the middle? And it's like, don't be too hard on yourself, but recognize these factors. Recognize that it's expensive to do business here. Recognize that people who are in the club or in the music venue industry, they are suffering. They are suffering horribly. Like, some of them fold up and close up and go away. Some of them, you know, all they can do is just hope that they make the bills this month. And this is reality. I mean, with a few exceptions, like maybe the Torch Club, I don't know the ins and outs of their finances, but I feel like they're so very well established as this is what we do. We are a music venue. And people know that, and they've come to expect that, and they know what they can get away with. And that's why it's like the top of the top of the top of what they can afford to pay. They know what that is. They're not being dicks to you. They don't not like your band. They don't not want you to play. They can't afford you, because when you're there, you know, with your 10 friends or 20 friends even, you know, and maybe you do have a really excellent following, you know, when they have you there, there is an expectation. Like, if you say, well, I have to have a $600 guarantee because I deserve it. You probably do. You probably deserve $1,000. I know how much work it is. I see you load in your equipment. I see you sweat your ass off for 3 sets. I see you coming together with these other people and practicing and rehearsing and trying so hard to make this happen. I get it. I totally understand it. But it's like, are you good for 60 paid people at $10 a head? Are you? Is your band going to bring in 60 bodies to that club to eat and drink and be there? No. The short answer is no. And how I know that is because I've booked a bajillion different bands. I've booked the Blasters. I've booked Wayne Hancock. I've booked Deke Dickerson. I've booked Big Sandy. I have booked the Quakes. I have booked so many different acts in this town. And I know what I can, I don't make guarantees. I don't make promises anymore because I know no matter how freaking awesome I am and how pretty my flyer is and how hard I worked on it and how I flyered and did social media and got my friends roped into it. It's like, this is, if you can get 50 people to any club in this area, you're a god in my eyes. You're a freaking god. You are a god. Like, that's all I can say about that. It's like, just know that it's like, this area is hostile. And I mean, I feel like I'm so grateful for the people that I have connected with and that I have met that kind of, you know, are that, I call it the shot in the arm, where it's like, they're here to kind of uplift and elevate the whole scene. They're here to make new things happen. They have new ideas. They're bringing new things to the table, and it's so fun and it's so exciting. But it's like, it is the biggest uphill climb ever. I truly, truly thought 15 years ago when I started putting on shows, I mean, I, you know, my heyday, if you will, was like the 90s, where it's like, I would go into clubs, like I would go see Deke Dickerson at the Old Ironsides, and you'd have to wait to get in because they couldn't let you in because they were over capacity. And you'd have to sit outside and wait until somebody left so you could get your butt inside there. I remember that.
Those were the good old days.
I remember that. So it's like, did it happen? Yes, it did. Have I seen it happen? Yes, I have seen it happen. Does it happen now? Absolutely not. And there's many, many, many factors. Most of it has to do with like people who were in that 90s heyday, you know, like me and Eva and a whole bunch of our friends. Most of us either have kids, we've moved out of the area, maybe we've even moved out of the state. Not this gal. She's still down to kick it around with me. But I mean, it's really like, it's so different because it was like that. It's not like that now. And it is because that core base of people that were swing dancing and going to rockabilly shows and getting all dressed up and riding their cool rides and all that stuff, they're gone. They are gone. They've moved on. They're old.
They're old.
They're, you know, whatever, they're breeding, they have kids, they're doing whatever they're doing. They moved out of the area, they're not here to support it. So that's like probably the number one factor. The number two factor is like, especially like the midtown, downtown, sort of central Sacramento area, that area is full of people way younger than me who don't, not only do they not have a clue about the kind of music that we love and are into, they don't really give a shit either. All they really want to do is eat a pretzel and drink a craft brew at your local frickin' beer garden or wherever, because that's what they're into. Like, I mean, the bars that are in Midtown now, like the Cabin, and like, that's where we're headed. We're not headed to like a divey, rootsy.
If you are a friend of us on Instagram, you have seen our the Cabin experience.
I mean, it's just changed a lot. It's changed a lot. In addition to all of the changes, again, this area is not a hotbed for culture. It's not a hotbed for music. We have some amazing people here, and they are bucking the system, and they are working really hard to change that, and I am one of those people, but it's just, it is the biggest uphill climb. But just know, you know, and this is what I tell bands when they call me, I mean, and I still get phone calls, like, let's put on a show, let's make a thing happen. I'm like, okay, cool. Who's going to pay us? You know, and the answer is nobody. And you are going to be dependent on those door sales, and that's the reality. Like, it's just a very rough climate, and if I could have figured out a way out of it by now, I would have. I definitely would have. But I mean, I have yet. I've done free shows. I've done benefit shows. I've done festivals. The last few years, I've just kind of aligned myself with large festivals that have an actual large budget. Like Berry Festival, like Rockabilly Extravaganza, like the Santa Maria Car Show, where I slide in bands that I want to see. And that's like, that's my best tactic, because I mean, we just don't have the people here to support it. We just don't have that base support of people who love and appreciate rockabilly or roots music or Americana, whatever you want to call it. And even in like my country outlaw friends, I mean, it's such a small clique. It's really a small little group of folks. So yeah, that's my rant.
But I'm going to chime in on the shady thing. And if someone played there and didn't think they made enough money, this venue, Jason Boggs has put, you know, he's put aside like enough money to have people come through. It's one of a few.
Yes.
Backyard is the other. They have an entertainment budget, and this is built into their night. So they're not depending on you to bring 10, 20, 50 people. They're saying, play your music, get some new fans. And when you do have that, and oh, by the way, these places are free to get in. So
right, Sackyard and Shady, sorry. Free every night
and
of the week.
They
free.
Allow you yes. to put a tip jar up. I mean, so yeah. Whoever thinks they're being jaded, if you didn't make tips that night, I know some of my friends that have played at Sackyard and Shady, they make a few extra bucks in tips, you know. You're not paying to get in, but you know, you want to contribute.
Or maybe you sold a few CDs
or whatever.
A t-shirt or whatever.
If you think you deserve $500, $600, $1,000, then don't play those venues that want to just bring music and culture to whoever comes to the show or whoever comes to the venue or to come and drink and eat. You're going to gain new fans from this.
Like, absolutely.
And it's just
The hope. I mean, yeah. The reality is, and I've had this conversation with several of my musician friends, the truth is, you know, like my friends who play at different wineries and breweries and, you know, venues sort of outside the area, those people, they don't care about your music. They don't care what you have going on. They don't give a shit about Eddie Cochran or whatever, whatever. They don't care about that stuff. They just are like, wow, this is cool. I can do my white people dance to this. I love it. I'm going to drink a beer. I'm going to have a glass of wine, whatever. I'm going to have a good time. But it's not like they're going to go home and go, you know, Stray Cats. He said that was a Stray Cat song. I'm going to Google that and look that up. You know, well, if you don't know who the Stray Cats are, you probably are dead or I don't know. But like, you know, it's, I'm happy for my musician friends that go play, you know, the hot dog place or the brewery or the winery and they get their money because good for you, you figured out a way to actually make a buck. Good for you. But the reality is those are not your people. Those are not your fans. They are not going to follow you. Maybe they'll follow you. Maybe they'll come next time. If you come back to that same place, maybe they will. But at the end of the day, you know, are they people that are in our scene or our culture? They're really not. They're really not. You know, we appreciate them. We value them. It's great. And maybe we'll make a couple of fans. But that's not the point. The point is that these places that we're mentioning have set aside a certain amount of funds. Do what you want with it. Promote it or don't promote it. Bring your merch or don't bring your merch. Bring your best show or don't bring your best show. Bring some new flyers for your next show or don't. Like, it's up to you. All of this, it's business, right?
And we're not specifically talking about, like, our friends. Because I think our friends that play music appreciate anybody new that comes, that says, God, I never knew.
Mm-hmm.
You're amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And, but what it really comes down to is, like, if you're going to play a venue, if someone gives you the opportunity to play a venue,
make it the best
that you can.
Absolutely.
Especially Shady. Like, that is like, what is a real jazz club? I don't think it's meant to be a real jazz club.
Well,
the thread
started out with somebody saying they wanted to see a quote, real jazz club in Sacramento. And then, of course, somebody chimed in and said, well, Shady Lady, we can see jazz at Shady Lady. He books jazz bands. And then the conversation was, but it's not, the focus isn't on music. The focus isn't on music because nobody wants to see it. There's 12 of us. I can count them on two hands. How many people that like what we do and like this music?
I just did a weird finger thing. That was odd. No, but there is a jazz place I just discovered. If you want to go to a true jazz bar, on Stockton Boulevard.
Cool.
Kind of shady, but
sounds
hey,
awesome.
It's a real jazz joint. And so, like, if someone wants to go see real jazz and they're maybe not afraid to hang out on Stockton Boulevard, hey,
it's
how
awesome.
About it?
What's the name of it?
I don't know. I just heard about it.
It's awesome, and she's keeping it
to
herself.
I'm going to find out, but I know the place, and it's past 15th Avenue, but I just don't know the name. It's like, sometimes there's motorcycles out in front. It's like, if you're going towards, like, Fruit Ridge. Like, but it's just past 15th. It's just on this little corner. It's
and they play jazz?
They play jazz.
Live jazz?
Live jazz.
Live jazz.
Because I think wasn't more to the Hideaway, which used to be Cheers.
Yes.
They were like a jazz blues place, right?
Back in the day. I'm not familiar with what that venue used to be, but I did know that they used to have Colt 45 on tap. I heard tale.
Colt 45.
Isn't that Billy D's? Like,
yeah, I think so.
Oh,
yeah.
We love the Billy D.
Yeah.
But how rad.
Yeah.
So anyway, I mean, listen. You're going to the Shady Lady, really? If you're not into the music, I know I go because they do have bands that I want to see.
Absolutely.
There. But some people just go to eat or just to have one of their specialty drinks.
That's it. Like,
they don't care about the music.
No, they don't.
So, you know,
and you're
whatever.
Not going to change their mind because you opened a million-dollar jazz music venue. You're not going to change their mind. These people like what they like. They come, like she said, for the drinks and the food.
And I mean, yeah, is it unfortunate? Yes. You know, can we maybe change that? Maybe a few people. We might be able to change a few minds, possibly. You know, that's why we're doing this. We want to promote your shows, your music, your new CD, your festival. We want to promote that because we're grateful that we have it, number one. And number two, it's like, you know, I mean, how else are we going to keep this stuff going? You know, how else can we perpetuate what we love in this area? Like, I mean, truthfully, without the, like, a few, like, five different folks that I know, this stuff just wouldn't even happen. It would just evaporate and go away. So, yeah, definitely, you know, appreciate those places, even if it is a $200, $300, $400 guarantee, and that's all you make. Be grateful that you have it, because...
Be grateful you don't have to pay to play.
Which is the norm in a lot of other places. Which is the norm. Yeah. Yes. I mean, and here's the thing. It's like we were saying before, make the best of the situation. Bring your merch. Ask for tips. You know, bring flyers for your next show. You know, maybe do like a free burned CD and hand it out to some people.
A little PR is good. PR goes a long way.
Absolutely. I mean, it is the business of music. It is the business of music.
Yes.
Music, it's a creative thing. We love it. We appreciate it for the art that it is. But at the end of the day, you guys, it is a business. If you're not conducting yourself in a business-like way, you're probably going to be boo-hooing somewhere that you didn't get paid enough. And I mean, if you want to get paid in this area and you're watching this and you're in a band and you're like, but I deserve more money, go play a brewery, winery, go play a wedding. Because, and that's the other thing, if you play these breweries and wineries, they have music budgets because they're selling $30, $40, $60, $100 bottles of wine or beer or kegs of beer, whatever. They have money to pay you and you'll get like wedding gigs. I know musicians that this works for. They get really good private gigs as a result of doing those gigs and they get paid. You have to travel a little bit, but the truth of the matter is, you know, like I had somebody ask me, like, why is it that I can go to the gold country or out of the area and these people like love, worship, and adore me, but down here in the city or in other urban city areas, they can't get appreciated or liked or loved or paid? And I mean, the reason is because, again, down here, you're competing not just with bands, you're competing with this lifestyle that is this area. And in other urban areas, if they don't know you, they don't love you yet. You have to like cast the seeds before something can grow. You know, give away those CDs, give away a download, a free download, you know, do something that entices people to check you out, love you, and want to be around you. And there's a few people that are really, really, really good at that self-promotion. And I mean, it's hats off to them. And you know, I mean, if you're a traveling band or you're a band that's trying to break into a market, get onto a bill with somebody who's making it happen. Follow those bands that are making it happen and get on their bill. Even if you have to eat one and not get paid a lot, introduce yourself, your music to those people. That's how you break into a market. That's how you get in. You're not going to get in otherwise. And I mean, it is rough. And I mean, again, just like hats off to all my musician friends. I love you. I appreciate you so much. Thank you for making my life better. Thank you for making our area better. Thank you for making this area colorful and fun, because without you, it would so super suck here.
It would so super be Sacramento.
Sacramento. Yes.
If you're not raising babies here and you're single and whatever and you love music, it's Sacramento for you.
True.
Really. True story. Because I am living proof.
It's, yeah. Well, I mean, we make the most of it, right?
We do.
Just like you guys have to, too. We make the best of what we have. And, you know, everything is what you put into it. So, you know, if you want something great to come of it, you have to be that change. The saddest part of like this area for me right now is just like when people approach me and ask me, and I, you know, they want to do a show here and there's nowhere to put them. I used to book Torch Club, Starlight Lounge, Blue Lamp, Hideaway, Stag, Distillery.
I can't even think of all of those places.
I booked all of these different rooms, and I'm down to two now, guys. Two different rooms that are like, yeah, okay.
We might have one more, though. I made a connect.
Yay, more on that later. But it's just hard. It's just hard here, you guys.
Yeah. So, I mean, really support local music. If you're a band and you're getting $300, get that tip jar out. Tell people, like, we accept tips. Sell your merch.
Make some CDs. Make some little homemade, you know, CDs and give them away for free so
absolutely.
That those people come to an actual paid, you know, like a place that is, you know, has you on a bill with multiple bands and you guys are all getting paid from the door or whatever. Mm-hmm. I personally think that when someone promotes music and brings in bands, international bands, bands that have played in other countries, that the door, you should get the door and you should get part of the booze sales. You know why? Because we're bringing in people to your bar that might only have 20
people.
That's
a conversation, a whole nother level.
But
the
I'm just
promoter
saying,
side of it. Yeah.
Yeah, promoter side. Mm-hmm. You know, and so we can pay those bands. It's not that any promoter is really making any money. We get the excitement of seeing like a full bar with people that enjoy the music. And yes, we'd like to make a few extra dollars because of all the work that goes into promoting. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
But if your bar only has 20 people on a Friday night and we bring a band and then they have, you know, 80 people, I'm pretty sure your bar is doing a little better than it did the Saturday and the Saturday and the Saturday before that. Just saying. So,
well, and that's true, and that's true. I mean, and the promoter side, you know what, that is a whole nother dynamic.
And a couple percentage of the bar isn't going to kill you because, you know what, we just had a bunch of people buying food and booze from you.
Right.
Just saying.
Well, and there are some places that I work with where they do offer maybe a percentage, but it's true. I mean, you know, if you're out there and you're like, well, I would like to go maybe play this bar or that bar, or this bar or that bar, that is good information to be equipped with because when you go to talk to them, the truth of the matter is they don't want to give up anything. They don't want to give up anything. And just for your own information, not only do we typically not get paid a red cent, we actually do pay for the privilege of being at a venue and selling their booze and selling their food or whatever they got going on, because they charge. I mean, if you're a promoter and you want to put on a show at bar XYZ, they're going to charge you for that security guy because it's not going to come out of their pocket. They're not going to pay that security guy because they don't need that security guy if they're not having live music. And that's like, that has to do with the law, right? Because if you're having live music, or if you're at a certain capacity, you have to have that security guy in place. And it can't just be any guy. It's got to be like a carded guard guy. And they pay them by the
hour.
I'm
going to get my guard card.
So she can be my muscle.
Yeah.
So, you know, you have to pay. You have to pay that. That's number one. And you usually have to pay for the sound also. Most of the shows I've done in Sacramento, I paid for the security. I paid for the sound right off the top.
We need to learn how to do sound.
And then I know. Sound engineering school. And then I would always give all of the money to the bands. I've never, ever, 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 with the exception of like the bigger festivals that I do, I've never cut myself in or asked for a fee. I do it because, like she was saying, we really do want Deke Dickerson to come back to Sacramento. We want to see Wayne Hancock. We want to see Big Sandy. These bands would not come here if I couldn't make that crap happen. And I don't know how I continue to pull it out of my ass, but I do. And you know, I mean, that is stuff that nobody sees that stuff.
So can I just say also thank you, Elvis, for bringing some of these friends that
new
you have met along the way.
New.
And convincing them to share whatever you guys are getting paid at these venues. And you're willing to do that to bring some new culture and some new music to Sacramento. We really appreciate
bands
it.
Bands that would never, ever, ever be here otherwise. We really
absolutely think that, you know, thank goodness you can do that. And, you know, he puts them up in his home and he treats them right. And you know, he's not getting anything out of it. But
it's
thank you for bringing some new guys out here so that we can experience.
Yep.
Like Matt Codina, you had him on your last show, and Josh. And, you know, there's just...
And he's got plans, you guys, for the fall time because we've been talking.
Oh, I'm so excited.
I'm so excited, too. I'm very excited for the things that are coming. And hello, Nancy, and hi, Melissa, and hi, Diana, again. thanks, you guys, for watching us.
I know we're running late today, but because, you know, of the YouTube thing and because of me, because clearly I don't know... I'm on Mexican time. I don't know if anyone's ever heard that, but it is a thing. So, anyway, did we want to just mention this real quick?
Sure, why not?
That's on the last, because we're really not on a time limit on this thing here. But, Baja Bop.
In October, we're going to be there. Yes. You guys got to go. Get your tickets.
There's a lot of great musicians. Absolutely. And again, wait, did we, Elvis is on this as well.
Yeah.
Yes. So
Elvis and Wayne Hancock. Yes, it's going to be such a good show.
A great time. It's a 3-day cruise, mm-hmm. right, to Baja. And this is their second annual. And last year looked so fun. And I'm so upset that I didn't go because it looked amazing.
I know.
But also Big Sandy will be the MC.
Yep. Ooh, and I think, I mean, it's, you can see there's a whole bunch of different really good acts that are going to be there. It leaves from Long Beach. You put down a deposit. You have time to pay off, the whole amount for the cruise. And they have various different levels. And, you know, if you want like a cabin on the inside or on the
We're getting one on the inside because I don't want to see the ocean because of Jaws. And Mega. And the mega shark.
We'll do an episode from the ship where I push her over. No, we won't.
No.
I love this girl.
She would never push me over.
You guys, so yeah, the website for that is thebahabop@gmail.com for the email, and it's bahabop.com for the website. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. So.
Woo! She's not going to push me overboard, but if she does, keep this video. You've heard it live.
When she comes up missing in Mexico.
Yeah, because you know, that happens.
That's scary.
Like, when the wives and the husbands go on a cruise and the wife suddenly is missing or the husband suddenly missing.
What happened?
Ooh. Oh my God, I don't know. Yeah, so you guys, really.
Oh my God.
Or so I might have just escaped to France and I am living in France and nobody knows.
International superstar, woman of mystery. She'll have just
eloped. The Rockabilly Diva.
She will have just eloped somewhere off of the cruise and like took her little private jet somewhere.
Ooh, I want a private jet. That sounds nice.
She deserves a private jet, don't you think?
Hashtag sugardaddies.com.
Sugar babies.
Yes. So anyway, we're getting a little silly, but we, you know, anyway.
It's what we do.
It's what
music,
we do.
Music, girl talk, music. That's what we do. That's all we do. So, we'll be back next Sunday, 1 o'clock. If you guys have any ideas, if feedback, if you want to see or mention any shows, festivals, car shows, pinup contests, whatever you got going on, definitely hit us up at winewomenandsonggals@gmail.com or on Instagram. We're also on Instagram. We're also both on Facebook. I'm Shauna Honkinen. This is Eva Graf.
She has Fun Monkey, though. If you want to do music, hit her up on the Fun Monkey.
All of my events are on Fun Monkey Entertainment on Facebook. You can find us there. Come and see us at a show. Like I said, we list and show all of the different flyers on our Instagram, so you can definitely figure out where we're going to be next. And
we're definitely going to try to do the Danny Morris.
Oh yeah,
Jesse
Daniels. You guys got to go.
Wednesday night.
It'll
be it's going to be a week of music. My weekends are normally not so musical these days, but my weeknights, Pixies on Tuesday, and then Torch Club on Wednesday, so.
She's the gal on the go, way more than me.
Yeah.
Catch her out and about. She's out and about.
Bye, guys. Thanks for watching.
Thank you
Sorry
so much.
Sorry the YouTube thing was weird. We gotta figure that out.
You guys, I don't even know what's going on with that. We will hopefully have all of that sorted. If nothing else, I'll be uploading this video to the YouTube so that you guys can see it there. And thank you again so much for watching, and we love you. Go see a show. And see
and
you next
cheers.
Time. Cheers.
Happy Sunday, fun day.
Yes.
Bye-bye, guys.
Bye. Me.
Present.